hope that you had a blessed Christmas, and that Christ has his presence and place in your lives and in your gatherings. I know this year it's been different with social distancing and separation from friends and family, but I pray that the peace of Christ and the presence of Christ brought you joy and comfort and peace on your holiday celebration for you and your family and your friends. But today we're glad that you're here to celebrate and continue our joy in the birth of God into our world, the birth of Christ. Again, welcome, and we're so glad that we have a joy to the world to celebrate. Now I'm going to ask you to join with me in our call to worship as we read the psalm together, Psalm 148. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise God in the heights. Praise God, all God's angels. Praise God, all God's hosts.
Praise God, sun and moon. Praise God, all the shining stars. Praise God, you rise the heavens, and you waters above the heavens.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for God commanded and they were created.
God has established them forever and ever. God fixed their bounds, which cannot be passed.
Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps, fire and hail, snow and frost, stormy winds fulfilling God's command.
Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds.
The kings of the earth and all the peoples, princes and all rulers of the earth, young men and women alike, old and young together.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for God's name alone is exalted. God has raised up a horn for God's people. Praise from all God's people, for the people of Israel who are close to God.
Praise the Lord. Please join me in our opening prayer. Almighty God, God, Lord Almighty, the day of celebrating Christmas has come and gone, but today we gather to remember that the Christ of Christmas is with us now and forever. As the people of Jesus' church, let us be empowered and inspired that He is the Word which has become flesh and dwells in me, you, and all. We offer praise to God for the Holy Child of Bethlehem, who came for us so that we might be called the children of God. Amen. I'd like to now invite you to stand, and we'll sing Angels from the Realms of Glory. Angels from the Realms of Glory. Let's stand together.
Thank you.
be seated. If we say we have no sin, then we're deceiving ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, our God, who is merciful and just, will forgive us of all our wrongdoings and all our unrighteousness. Let us, in that confidence, make our confession together. Mighty God, Jesus came to this world as a powerless, vulnerable, and humble baby. But we confess that we admire the powerful, the independent, and the self-confident leader. We have responded to the coming of your word made flesh with puzzlement, not joy, and proclaimed this good news with half-hearted commitment, not shouts of hallelujah. In the darkness of our weaknesses, we hide afraid that the light of the world will shine too brightly on our flaws. Forgive us, God, and move us to welcome the Christ child into our hearts so that our attitudes overflow with faithfulness and our actions are filled with the passion of Jesus' love. Amen. Let us now take a moment for personal confession, reflection, and listening for God to speak to our hearts this morning. Christ was born into this world to save sinners like you and me. And that baby Jesus, as a man, took our sins upon his body on the cross, that we might be dead to sin and alive to all that is good. My friends, believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Let us now stand and share the peace of Christ by making some noise, honking our horns, clapping our hands, and making noise to share our Christ. Adoption has changed. child, then also an heir through God. And now from Luke, the second chapter, continuing the story of the childhood of Jesus with the presentation at the temple. And when the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, they brought him up from Jerusalem to present to him to the Lord, as is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves and two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came to the temple, and when the parents brought the child Jesus to do for him as was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you have dismissed your servant in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for glory to your people, Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. And she was of great age, having lived with her husband for 7 years after her marriage. Then was a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped there with fasting and praying night and day. At that moment she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had finished everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee, to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favor of the Lord was upon him. We thank God for these words. so many dreadful days, I hope this intergenerational message from Luke is a word of joy and hope for you and me, breaking into those divisions that may separate us by generations. I believe this witness of Simeon and Anna breaks into our hearts to bring us together, especially in this time where we so need to be together. Any notion of our usual Christmas and holidays and New Year's has been disrupted by this pandemic. But I hope that this passage reminds us of the real power of presence of Christmas. The real power and presence of what was seen and shared when Christ came into our world. You see, when we really see this Christmas event with eyes of faith, we see, like Simeon, a clarity of God's vision, and we're able to voice the power of God's promises. If we have vision like Anna, we can see and know what God is doing, even in this broken and disturbed world. And we can tell how God makes promises and does it and fulfills them. When we know the joy in the midst of a Christmas troubled and broken with a pandemic, then our faith lets us see and know the blessings of God, and then empowers us to share it, so that we, like Simeon and Anna so long ago, might be among those that have eyes to see and voices to tell. Mary and Joseph were following the law of their day, the custom from Leviticus for mother and child. The law required that the mother have a ritual of purity, and that the child be commissioned at 40 days. And so we would assume that as people of faith and devotion, Mary and Joseph have arrived at the temple 40 days after Jesus has been born. There, as they enter the temple with so many other pilgrims, they enter the court. There, they begin to make their offerings of birds, of simple offerings. They encounter a regular at the temple, a man devout and holy, a man who had spent a majority of his life in devotion to God and prayer, who stayed in the temple and the temple courtyard night and day. Simeon. And as they came to make their offering, and we don't know how, in what miraculous way, but eyes of faith, Simeon sees who this child is. And like the commercial that you've seen so much of the grandfather who does the weights, you don't know what he's doing. He's exercising, walking. Have you seen this, lifting the weights? And then at the end, you see that it's all about lifting his grandchild. I can imagine that's Simeon as he is introduced to the Christ child. Then in his joy, he takes him from Mary and lifts him high into the air and proclaims to everyone in the temple that this is the one who is the consolation of Israel. This one is the Messiah. And if that were not enough of this beautiful intergenerational picture of ancient man Simeon and the young parents and the baby Jesus, in common. shows how we are blessed here at Florissant Presbyterian. We're lacking on the young side, but we're not lacking on the experienced side. We've been blessed with decades and decades, and together centuries and centuries of faith gathered right here. But we have to have eyes of faith to see. Now, we don't see the baby being brought for dedication. But in the midst of all our struggles, in the midst of all our griefs and losses, may this light of Christ shine in us to have our eyes of faith to see that this baby that came to the temple so long ago is with us today. Just as the Holy Spirit, it says, was upon Simeon, and how he knew that before he died he would see the Messiah, that same Spirit is upon you and me in Christ, opening up our eyes of faith so that we might see in one another and in our scriptures and in our world that God is working for reconciliation, for consolation and reconciliation. And if we have eyes of faith to see and to know that Christ is present with us, don't we also, with Simeon and Anna, need voices to go and tell? They had waited so long. You can imagine the anticipation that Simeon must have had, that as he picked up his child, he can't be contained. He must tell. And Anna, childless, to hold this child, the excitement, she couldn't be contained. She had to go and tell. And my friends, as the Spirit is upon us, and as we long for eyes of faith, may we see and then go and tell. Go and share this blessing that you and I have had, this peace and this joy that comes to us in this Christmas season. It's not always easy to see this joy or promise today in the midst of a pandemic. But let me tell you about the Brundages of Belleville, Alan, Ann, and Andrew. Alan had been out of work since March. They were broke. They were barely hanging on to their home and having enough to eat through others' generosity. But they wanted to celebrate Christmas together. This young family wanted to celebrate Christmas together. So Anna was reading about people during the Depression and how they dealt with having nothing. And one of the stories was of people taking the Sears and Roebuck catalog and cutting out the things that they desire, they wish it would be their Christmas. And so Anne had an idea. So she got Alan and Andrews just by and told them her plan. So they got some old catalogs and magazines and they started clipping their pictures of what they wanted for Christmas. And they put them together in envelopes and they set the envelopes under their tree. And as Christmas morning arrived, with nothing in their bank account but love in their home, they decided to open their envelopes and see their presents. And as Alan opened his envelope, he saw that he got a brand new black Escalade that he wanted. And Anne opened hers, and she had the necklace, the diamond necklace from Jared's that she hoped her husband would buy her. And some new golf clubs that he wanted to have, and Andrew opened his, and there was the game console that he had dreamed up. And they were celebrating Christmas with their hopes. But then the final envelope, they pull it out, and it was Andrew's envelope. And as they opened it, and they saw what was in it, it was not a picture that Andrew had cut out, but one that he had drawn. And it was of Mom and Dad, Alan and Ann, and Andrew, holding a baby. Parents were at first a bit shocked, saying, you want a sibling? And they said, no. This is a picture of Mom and Dad and me and the baby Jesus. In our world today, with the struggles of death around us and the pandemic getting worse, of people out of work for long times and worried about how they're going to make ends meet and pay their rent, in a time when people are struggling for recognition and equality and justice, it can be hard to have eyes of faith. But if we come together, intergenerationally, I believe, like Anna and Simeon and Joseph and Mary and Jesus, concerned, and then lift them up together in prayer to our God. I do have one concern. This is for Chris's Aunt Janine, who is in a dilemma over surgery and battling cancer. So we want to remember Janine and her family, Chris's family, on prayers today. Other special prayers? Yes. Yes.
I'd like to bring my hand to you. Prayers for my sister Jan and her husband Bennett and her son Jesse, who all have COVID.
And, Sue, could you tell us that again with the microphone? It's right beside you. I'm having a hard time hearing myself.
My sister Jan, her husband Bennett, and my nephew Jesse, who have all been diagnosed with COVID.
Yes, I'm sorry, Sue. You got a bit bad out of this. Yes, Robert.
Our good friend Terry Schaffner, who was in the hospital with COVID, is now home and has recovered. But with concern is our daughter Randy, who has come down with COVID.
I see.
Even after she got the shot.
We're sorry,
And our hearts go out to all that are suffering with the COVID and the loved ones that are tending to them. Our hearts and our prayers go with each and every one of them.
Roland, this is it's very difficult. I know. The first person that you announced, you said Terry Schaffner.
Terry Schaffner.
Another Terry. Okay, my hearing. Yes, okay. Thank
yours
you.
And mine both.
Yes, thank you. I just wanted to make sure that we're getting the right.
Sister, she's 92. I just found out.
John, you have turned off the mic, I believe. This happened because I cannot hear you.
It's on.
It's on. Okay. All right.
Yeah, now I can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. With the hearing aids, I can't hear myself very well.
I understand. We're so glad that you're here.
Our sister, John,
and you're here, and it's all a blessing.
She's in the nursing home, palliative care.
Yes.
Kidney failure. I'd like prayers for her.
Yes, your sister.
Her name is Ann. A-N-N-A-N.
Yes. Thank you, John. Very scary. Any other joys are be with those who are caring for them with skill and knowledge and the art of medicine. Be with all those that need to know that there is hope. Now, Lord, we ask that you help us to have eyes of faith to see the goodness even in the struggle and to see how we may fit into your plan of care and love. Lord, in this time of so much heartache, help us to be instruments of healing and of your peace. Guide us in our sharing and our telling of your love that is today and tomorrow and always upon us as your children. And now, Lord, it's as children of God and as disciples of Christ that we come with the prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever. Amen. We will be celebrating Epiphany next week, although it's Christmas time. It's just the second Sunday of Christmas. During that week, there will be Epiphany. So next week, we will be taking a look at the wise man and their aftermath. Are there any announcements to be made? We're all looking forward to a new year and kind of settle down after the new year. We're going to start up some new ministries and a Sunday school class, but until then, we'll let you rest a little bit. So now let's stand and sing together our final hymn, Go Tell It on the Mountain. Oh, yes, I do remind you that we have our plate in the back for offering. Please, I know many of you are mailing in your pledges and your offerings, and also we have a PayPal account that you can online make your contribution and your pledges. Let's sing the doxology. Thank you.
Thank you.
My friends, we have our struggles and our heartaches, but we also have our joys and our hopes. May we have eyes of faith to see God working around us, even in these difficult times. And then may we have the courage and faithfulness to go and tell. Now may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you.